Howdy and welcome. You are listening to A Mom's Guide to Wine, a guided wine tasting with candid reflections on motherhood. Here we spill the tea, but never the wine. We are your hosts, Eliza James
and Rosie Gold,
and we are so glad you joined us for today's tasting adventure.
Full disclosure, for those with little ears around, 90% of our topics and language will be more on the R rating scale. Also, we are not professionals or experts. We are simply sharing our experiences and including some Google searches for support. We are amateur wine enthusiasts and professional moms. That is our skill set.
But first, the wine. Today's wine is from William Chris Winery. It is their... You have to keep it cold. It came with a wine, like a warning label on it. It is their Petillant Naturel Rosé. It should be a sparkling wine. I've been keeping it cold and on ice this whole time because the warning label says to. So literally it's a like legitimate like warning label. It says read before opening in like big bold letters, and they literally like tack it to the top of the bottle
to make you nervous that like the wine police are gonna come get you.
Like, for real, like I bought this wine specifically for this reason because I've never bought a wine like this before. It says, number one, store the bottle upright. Number two, do not shake or jostle the bottle in the hours prior to opening. Three, serve extremely cold. It says 36 to 40 degrees Fahrenheit. I didn't measure to see how cold I have it, but I literally had it in a bucket of ice. It sat in the fridge all night on the top shelf closest to like the circulating fan thingy. So I'm hoping it's really cold. And it says remove cap quickly and have your glasses ready to pour. I think we have our glasses ready.
We are ready.
I've got my bottle ready. I just took it out of the ice. And so let's pop it real quick.
Let me give it a quick shake.
No.
Let's
not do that. It's not like a how y'all imagine like a champagne bottle. It's got like the cork. This is literally like your pop top. So here we go. Ooh, it had nice like,
oh, beautiful.
Like, there's, like, smoke coming out of the top. It's really pretty. And it's got little bubbles now coming up the neck of the bottle. So it looks very happy. So let's go ahead and pour. So they make this using the methodod. Y'all are going to have to excuse me. I'm not good at pronouncing things. But it's an ancestral that was actually the predecessor to the creation of champagne and how Dom Perignon founded the champagne method. This wine is unique in that it is lightly bubbly and often cloudy because of the fermentation is finished inside the bottle and does not experience filtration. And they use a crown cap to complete the bottle. And they said it's because that's how it finishes the true ancestral method, which I think is really cool. And then the Petnat Rosé is mainly derived from the same Signy method, which is the use of some of the drained liquids from the pressing of the red grapes. So all of this is totally from the William Chris Vineyard website. You can totally check it out. But it is very cloudy, like, and it smells really good. It doesn't smell like a...
It has almost an orange color to it.
Yeah, it's very different. It's not what I was expecting. Like, when I opened the bottle, I expected it to be more of like a yellow color, but it's definitely more of an orange. Very peach toned, but it smells good.
Yeah, I definitely smell the fruitiness to it, but it's definitely not the strongest smell.
I like it. All right, here we go for a taste.
Hold that on my tongue.
I am, like, it's so bubbly. There are so many bubbles.
Yes, I think it just increases on your tongue.
Mm-hmm.
Upon contact.
That's pretty cool. Y'all, this is pretty tasty. I like it. I like it a lot. So, I don't know what I would say for flavor. Like, so maybe like apple, definitely.
I feel like it's earthy.
Very earthy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I'm trying to like let it swish around my mouth a bit. I like that the bubbles like follow down your throat. Like, it's so bubbly.
So bubbly. I love that it's a different color, because when you're serving multiple wines at the same time, like, you know when you've picked up that next wine.
Yeah, this one's definitely got a different color to it. This is nice.
All right. As it pertains to parties, anyway.
Yeah, if you were doing this, like, at a wine tasting party, This would be a nice thing to serve. So you usually start with, like, your sparkling wines first. And then, like, you move through, like, your array of wines. So this would be, like, a very nice starter because it's not tart.
Yeah.
But it's not sweet. Like, it's a very soft sweet.
Would you feel like it has a long finish to it, though? Because I feel like it's just lingering.
Yeah, well, it's the bubbles. Like, I think they feel like them going down your throat. So I would say it has a very long finish. This is nice. Like, I would probably drink this without... We were talking earlier about how most sparkling wines, you think of serving them, like, in your mimosas.
Absolutely. Because why not?
Because how else do you drink them? Because they don't usually taste good.
But this is actually good.
This is actually good.
Well, it's cool.
Yeah, like, I don't know how it's going
to
taste.
I'm following those instructions to a T.
We're going to put it back on the ice. Like, that's... We're going to keep it on the ice, and we're going to... Here, fill my glass again. Please, ma'am.
Absolutely.
So we're going to keep it... Y'all can hear the bubbles. Isn't that insane? So many bubbles.
And back on ice.
Back on the ice, because we're going to keep it cold. So the bottle itself is very, like, green in color. And, of course, the little cap that's on top of it, you have to think of it like your traditional soda bottle, right? Like, it is... literally what goes on top of a soda pop bottle. So when they talk about putting that cap on, that's all it was. I literally just used the bottle opener that I used to open my husband's beers. Super fancy, I know, but yes. It's what I have available. And it works. Like, the top came off super easy.
It didn't fly across the room.
It didn't fly across the room. Like, when you open corked wines, you never know. Doesn't matter how careful you are, you never know.
But we didn't shake it.
We did not shake it. We were super careful.
Maybe all wine needs a warning label.
Maybe so. Maybe we should put that out there. All winemakers, please put warning labels on your wine. That would be very helpful because then I don't have to guess, should this be cold? Should this be room temperature? Should I pour this over ice?
How much research do I need to do in order to successfully have this party?
Absolutely. The answer to this question was a little bit. Because, obviously, yes. I'm just that type of person. But, on the bottle, real quick, they do say this is... I have the 2020 version. I looked online last night. They have the 2019 you can buy from the vineyard. So, I feel like I'm just on top of things and buying it quicker than, you know, obviously they're selling it or something. I don't know. I felt really cool that, ooh, they have the 2019 online, but I got the 2020. So, it says it is 11.8% alcohol by volume, and it's a 750-milliliter bottle, so that's a lot. Oh, and it's created over in High, Texas. So
fun.
I thought it would be really cool. All our wines for season one are going to be Texas-based. I want y'all to know, Texas winemakers apparently don't make sparkling wine. Like, I don't know. I don't know if they just don't sell them in stores, because y'all, I was not traveling to... I mean, I would have. Let me back up. I would have traveled to a vineyard, but once
as
I get
an excuse.
There, but once I get there, leaving gets really hard.
So
then you're,
difficult.
You're just tasting all this,
and they just keep providing.
Yeah, as long as you got that card on file, man, they'll just keep bringing them to your table. So those are dangerous. I'm not allowed to go alone.
That's okay. I'm like the official DD. Of all time.
Well, that's why I take you along with me, so you can be my DD. Next time I'll call you. But literally, guys, like, I was trying to find a Texas wine that was sparkling, and I was very disappointed in my Texas people because I found two. I know of a third, but again, that I would have to go to a winery, and I didn't want to. Well, I mean, I wanted to, but I can't.
Not right now.
Not right now.
Because we're responsible moms.
We're responsible moms. That's another thing. We're moms, so we got to think on that side, too. So, but this wine is delicious, and I'm just going to sip it the whole episode. So, the episode starts getting crazy. We apologize in advance. There has been alcohol, and it is a high alcohol content, y'all. It's 11.8. So, if I fall out of my chair, y'all just pick me up off the floor. I'm sorry, I really like the bubbles. So, let's go ahead and start in. Who are Eliza and Rosie? You may be wondering.
Well, myself, I have a 3-year-old. about to be three, not quite three. And we've known each other for about six-ish years.
Yeah, it's going on at least six years.
We started off real strong, real fast.
It's true. We did. So we were hired for the same company around the same time, and so we had a lot of the same experiences going in. Then we got pregnant together at the same time. Yes. So
had all kinds of fun with that.
Oh my God, y'all. Pregnancy is not for the weak. Neither is motherhood. So shout out to all them strong mamas out there. But we were like work wives for like, yes. what, four, almost 5 years?
Yes.
We've been recently separated.
So sad.
Relocation issues. And so it's like we had to find an excuse to hang out again. I don't know. Like we wanted to be together so badly. And our husbands, being the great husbands they are. Who actually like each other. They've been super supportive.
Which is great.
Yeah. Super supportive of us. And they're totally getting to hang out right now and watch the children. Ha! Joke's on them. But we get to hang out together. And we were like, you know what? If we're going to hang out together, we might as well, like, I don't know, do a podcast about shit that we know.
Yes.
I don't
know. And putting our info out there.
Putting our info
out
there.
It could help.
Could help. So,
or it could just make you laugh. Like, who gets into that scenario? You know what? We did.
Chances are one of us has been in that scenario.
But we'll get into that.
We'll get into that. I swear to y'all, we've got some stories that will either make you laugh or make you cry. Like, is a bit
probably
of both.
To pity us.
Bit of both. So, So, obviously, we both have kids. Rosie has an almost 3-year-old. So, my youngest, my little boy, is right there behind hers. He is 3 months younger. My oldest, y'all, 16 and driving, so y'all have been warned to
wide
stay off
range.
The roads.
Yes.
You've been warned. And I also have, as she refers to herself, a preteen. She's super dramatic. So I've got a mean teenager, I've got the dramatic preteen, and I've got that terrifying toddler going for me. And so my household, y'all, is like chaos every day, all day. Until they pass out at night, and which they do, thank
God. Or we are lucky enough to have a nap.
Oh my gosh.
It's hard getting them to nap now.
I love naps. Naps are my fave, y'all. If y'all don't know about naps, y'all need to figure that. Even my older take naps because, you know what, mommy needs downtime.
It might be a little for the kid, but it's really for you.
It's really for the moms. Don't let that fool you, okay? So, we've been on similar paths. Like, we have worked since the time we were young. We've been around kids our entire lives. I don't know how else to say that. Like, we are working moms to, like, the extreme. I know I worked my way through school.
I started probably when I was, like, 8 years old, working for family members, getting paid somewhat, like, allowances. And then, throughout school, I worked full-time. In college, I worked full-time. So,
yeah, like,
I mean, I've been working for a very long time.
Yeah, putting myself through school. I got two kids while I was in college. So, I don't recommend that for everybody, but ladies, it's totally doable. So, don't put yourself down saying you can't do it. It's possible. It just sucks.
And find the right support for you.
And finding the support system is highly important. So, how we got into wine is we used to go to, like, these wine tasting parties, and we discovered I discovered I really like wine.
Yes.
Rosie participates.
I've never been a drinker, ever. Nothing against alcohol at all, obviously, but I just never have been a drinker, so whenever we do have these wine tasting parties, I always match up with my closest friend, typically my friend Eliza, who will finish off my glass quite nicely before the woman comes around and gives us more wine.
Yeah, I'm a good gal pal to have around because I'll totally take that bullet for you.
I sip and I pass, and I sip and I pass.
Which is also why Rosie has to drive me home at the end of those parties, because by the time everybody's had, like, their tastings, I've had, like, glasses.
Absolutely. So I'm just great helping parties. Out the team. That's all.
That's right. So we are very amateur when it comes to, like,